introduction to Java programming. Let us see how to begin Java program. You will click on Java button, whichever is on your desktop or the logo or the icon. You will see the bird will appear, and after that, this kind of project window will appear. This window is called project window. In this project window, you will go to project and then you will create a new project. In this new project, you will have to give the name of the project. The name I am giving introduction, right? And then you will choose wherever you are locating it. So that path will come automatically if you have any, or you may choose it as a different one if you want. If you have a previous version of Java, then also you will be able to see that a name option will come for the project. Give that and press OK. You will see this project named window will appear now. Can you see the name of the project appearing here on left top? You see BlueJay introduction project. Okay. Now I'll have to go to new class, and there I will have to create my first class. I am naming it program A. Okay. Then I click on OK. Then you will see a yellow color box that will have the same name as the class name which I gave now. This is the class representation in the project window. The project window has got these toolbar on top, like the names of project and. Now, when you double click on program window, you will find the program will appear. This is called the program window. In the program window, you will see there is a lot of sample written. The sample should not scare you because you don't have to understand all this now. What you do is you delete entire. To delete entire, I am using the keyboard shortcut Control A for selecting the full thing and then press delete to delete everything. Why I delete it? Because I am going to write what I want to write. Okay. So coming up is a sample program. See, this is the first program that I want you to see. Name is given as class program A. Then inside it, I'm telling you the minimum that you need to write to complete the program. There are other detailed ways also of writing a program. You can write public, static, void, main. I'm asking you to avoid writing the extra things for now. You will see in different places, there are different approach of introduction. My approach is to give you the minimum to start with. Now you see, in the program, those who have got a little bit of sense of programming, you will understand there are three variables A, B and C, where I am declaring them as integers, int for integers. I need to declare a variable before I use it, and then A is given a value which is 45, B is given a value which is 90. Just like that, I am putting two numbers in them, and C is adding them, and I am printing all three variables in a pattern. How? I am printing A, and then I am printing B, and then I am printing the sum as C. To run the program, you will have to compile. When you will click on this compile button, you will see a small message will appear at the bottom of the program window. Let me show you that message. That message will say you don't have any syntax error. Just a second. Let me take that screen to your view. It is little below the... Yeah, now you got it? See, here it shows class compiled, no syntax error. Syntax error stops the program from running. Okay, once you finish doing it, now you can see the project window which was kept open. I am going to do the screen adjustment. I am going to keep both of them open. I am not going to make any one of them full screen. Can you see? The project window has got program A and the program is written inside. Then I will do right click. When I right click on it, I will see new program A. I click on this. I will find name of instance. I will click on it. I will find a red color box, which is the object box. I right click on it. I will find main. This main is the main that is present in my program. I click on this. I will see an output window coming. This output window has come very tiny. Why? I don't know. But now look at the output. Can you justify the output? The output says A is 45. You see print. B is 90. And this ln here is bringing the next print statement in the next line. So A and B are getting printed side by side. After printing B, a new line where the third line, which is printing sum equal to, so is getting printed. I can change the numbers, I can change the operators, I can make it 72, I can make this 25, and I can change the symbol from plus to star if I want. And then if I compile it, then this should be changed logically, means meaningfully. I'll make this result. I could have made this product also. That is up to you. I'll compile it once again. You will see the stripes will go away. Whenever you compile, the stripes vanish. As I'm keeping this side, I click on this. I right click. I go to new program. And then I click on the name of instance. And then I click on right click on the red color object. Click on main. You will see the output comes on the output window. Do you understand now? You may have to see the video once again to learn the steps what after what. Okay?